Hey y'all, welcome back to my home. Today we're going to be making our artwork from my living room. We're going to be making upcycled envelopes. So the very first thing we need to do is find us an envelope. We're not going to go out and buy an envelope and waste our money. We're not going to go to the back room and find one. Instead, we're going to ask our parents if we could go through their junk mail. Chances are they got a stack of mail of bills that they've already paid online or people trying to sell them something that they'll let you go through. So find you a nice thick envelope and open it up. The nice thick ones usually have a copy of the bill that you got that you already paid online and a return envelope. And this is what we're going to be using to decorate, okay? You see the window on the front of it? We could cover this window with a mailing label, but we don't want to go out and buy mailing labels. Instead, we're going to use the envelope that our bill came in, and we're going to cut out a rectangle about the same size and glue it down. So you'll need your envelope and some scissors and glue to cut that out with. You'll also need a pencil to draw with and something to add color with. I'm using color pencils, but you use whatever you have on hand. If you've got some crayons, you can use crayons. They can make beautiful artwork. You could use markers. You could use paint, watercolor paint or acrylics. You could even use food coloring if you have some in your kitchen cabinets, if your parents will let you. Or coffee grounds, add water to it, make different shades of brown and paint it all like that. You could even put a collage on it. Pictures from magazines or cutout paper, or you could just use a pencil. If that's all you got, you still got all you need. Just flip that pencil over on its side and add different shades, dark shades and light shades, and you'll have a beautiful artwork. Finally, when we get through with our design on our envelope, we're going to write a letter. So you'll need some writing paper and a pencil or a pen to write your letter with. You might wonder why write a letter when you've got so many ways to communicate. You've got the internet, you've got email, you've got your phone that you could text on, you send Twitter messages, you send Facebook messages. So why write a letter? Well, there's a time we didn't have all of that, and we used to write letters, and it would make you feel so good when you'd go out to the mailbox and you would get a letter from a friend or a family member, and they just telling you everything that's going on in their life, asking you about yours, and then you get to go and write them one back. So you're going to need some paper and pencil to write someone a letter. I'm going to write my letter to my sister Teresa. I have two sisters, Teresa and Debbie. Teresa and I are both teachers, so we spend a lot of time together during the summer, and we usually go on vacation to the beach. This year we can't go to the beach because Miss Stacy's staying quarantined, and she's really bummed out about that. So I'm going to write her a letter, and I'm going to decorate my envelope with the beach scene. So since we can't go to the beach, I'm going to bring the beach to her. When I get ready to mail the letter, I'll need a postage stamp. And you get these from the post office. They cost 45 cents and it's worth every penny. So while I'm decorating my envelope with the beach scene, I want you to be thinking about who you want to bless with a handwritten letter because everyone loves a handwritten letter. And you can be thinking about that and that'll help you come up with your design.
Ticket for an aeroplane. Ain't got time to take a fast train. Lonely days are gone, I'm a going home. My baby just wrote me a letter. I don't care how much money I gotta spend. Got to get back to my baby again. Lonely days are gone, I'm a going home. My baby just wrote me a letter. When she wrote me a letter, said she couldn't live without me no more. Listen, mister, can't you see I got to get back to my baby once more? Anyway, yeah, give me a ticket for an aeroplane. Ain't got time to take a fast train. Lonely days are gone, I'm a going home. My baby just wrote me a letter. When she wrote me a letter, said she couldn't live without me no more. Listen, mister, can't you see I got to get back to my baby once more? Anyway, yeah, give me a ticket for an aeroplane. Ain't got time to take a fast train. Lonely days are gone, I'm a going home. My baby just wrote me a letter. My baby.
Ah!
Well, that was fun. As you see, I created a beach scene on my envelope to mail to my sister. Hopefully, you were thinking about the person you want to send your letter to, and you've got an idea for your design. When you get ready to mail it, you're going to want to put the person's address that you're sending it to right here. You're going to put their name, their street address, their city, their state, and their zip code. And up here in this corner, you saw me writing, you're going to put your address. You're going to put your name, your street address, your city, state, and zip code. Now, if you don't know the person's address, your parents may know it. If not, you might have to send them a little text message and tell them you need their address for something. But don't spoil the surprise. Let them be surprised by your special little package that they're going to get. Last thing, don't forget to put your postage stamp in this corner over here. Now, here's a little thing. When I was younger, if you put your postage stamp upside down, it means I love you. So I put my sister's upside down. That's just a little kick for you. And I have another idea for you while we're at it. And that is, why not collect about 10 of these and put designs on them throughout the summer? Just 10 different designs and color them and wrap a bow around it and give it to someone as a gift. It would make a wonderful birthday gift, or even put it up for a Christmas gift. It's not that far. We're halfway through the year now. So when you get through with this one, though, before you put it in the regular mail, if you would, just snap a photo of it and please send it to Miss Stacy via either the Webster Parish portal or a personal email, or if your parents have my cell phone number, which they probably do because I call most of them a couple of times already during the break, they could text it to me, or they could send it to me through Messenger, or just tag me on Facebook. But let Miss Stacy see a picture of your envelope. And until the next time I see y'all, I hope you stay creative and stay safe.
Lonely days are gone, I'm a going home. My baby just wrote me a letter. When she wrote me a letter, said she couldn't live without me no more. Listen, mister, can't you see I got to get back to my baby once more? Anyway, yeah.